I'm Peter. I work in teen empowerment. I'm a mental wellness ambassador, and this is my first year on the job.
I'm Jojo, and I'm a youth organizer with teen empowerment.
Just kidding. Okay.
Hi, my name is Eri. I work for LIPS, and this is my first year.
My name is Elias, and I work for teen empowerment, and I'm a youth organizer. This is my first year.
Drugs and violence don't really affect me personally, but it affects the people around me more because, me as a person, I know to stay away from that stuff, and if people, like, peer pressure me into, they try to peer pressure me into doing bad things such as that, I say no, and if they just push one more time, I just say no and just make it final. But more people around me are pressured into doing it rather than saying no. Like, for example, one of my friends, he got pressured into it, and then he got caught with weed in his bag, and he got caught by his parents. But his parents didn't really punish him that much for something that should be punishable for a lot more, because they just punished him by, like, grounding him for, like, a week and then taking away his drugs. And I feel like that should be, like, they should have, like, gone to another step, because that's a dangerous thing for a teenager to have, and it could really hurt them in more ways than one.
I would tell them that with all gun violence and drugs, there is always going to be something that's going to come back and not haunt you, but something that's always come back to you. And basically, there's always violence involved, regardless of whether you want it to happen, or you're distributing the drugs, or you're smoking them, or doing whatever you are supposed to be doing with the drugs. Supposed to be doing. And I guess it can influence the way you are in the future. Maybe not always, but sometimes it will. And I guess there's always violence bound to come out of it. Big danger is death. I mean, that's something that can come unexpectedly from being in, like, bad relationships with people. Certainly, being in regards to people who are, like, distributing the drugs, or you're not going along, you're not paying them for what you're getting or whatever. But I guess even, like, injuries, or maybe, like, the time taking something valuable or something that priceless from you, like a family member or something.
I just say, if you know that someone's going to try and peer pressure you into doing something, you just completely stay away from those people. You don't need those kinds of people in your life influencing you to do these things you feel like you don't need to do, because that just takes away your individualism and gives you that group mentality, thinking that you need to do something. So I say just stay away from those people. Really terribly, actually, because I know recently we had an assembly regarding drug use, drug abuse, things like that. And, I mean, no one really acknowledges what's going on. No one really pays attention. I know some people like to skip it too. And I know an assembly every month isn't going to help anybody get to the bottom of this issue.
It's not that bad because they address it, but I don't think it's enough, because I think they should, like, talk about it more in advisory and those classes.
Lisa, I guess the school should do a better job in, I guess, like, taking control of the situation, because at the moment, I guess the teens have more say, and, like, they're thinking about more things than the school is, and I guess the school is thinking, like, to do something rapidly would be the best idea, but it's not, and so that's why they retracted the assembly that they were supposed to be. They should take an example, and they should take pride in what the students are trying to do, and they're trying to accomplish something that would benefit the whole school and not just, like, getting it out of the way and getting out the trouble that has passed, like, an example, like the two boys who lost Tenzin and Kevin. I guess the school should take an example, and they should do something big instead of just something small, like 30 seconds of silence in school, because if it's something big, everyone's going to pay attention, including other school districts. They're going to take an example, and when something else happens in that city, they're going to take an example and say, oh, some boy high school did this, we can do something just the same size as that.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace to those who died because of drug addiction and or gun violence.
All right, and that is a wrap.